I'm a student, but after graduated from my university 20 days ago.
Oh, congratulations. What did you study? What was your degree in?
Yes, my major is English. I teach English for students. And I was teaching at for a phone break, teaching English teaching assistant.
Oh, okay, sure. Well, I'm here in Seoul, South Korea right now to speak at a seminar organized by the State Department for English teachers from 10 countries in East Asia, including Vietnam. What advice would you give people who are trying to improve their English?
I think the best way for an English learner is to start with listening skill. They first try to listen to movies with English subtitles, and then they can learn new vocabulary with learner advanced dictionary. They can try to mimic the pronunciation in the dictionary, so it can help them to listening when the words are in the long sentence. Yeah, and then for Vietnamese people, we do not have too many chances to talk with foreigners. So it's a little difficult for Vietnamese to enhance their listening skill. So the most important thing to Vietnamese people and other English learners, if they want to enhance their listening skill, is try to mimic the American and British accent. Because if they can speak as well as the American and British, they can listen to them. If they pronounce the word correctly, they can recognize the word when it's in a sentence. Hence, they can improve their listening skill. I have one question for you.
Yes.
When we gave our students a tape record, they listen to them. They can recognize, they can understand the tape. But when they step out from the university, they step out from the class, they talk with the foreigners, they cannot understand them. Can you help me to identify the differences between listening in the class and listening in the real life situations?
I think the one difference is that often when you listen to recordings, it's professional. Often it's professional speakers. It's actors or it's announcers, and so. It's not like natural speech where there are false starts and people speak fast and don't necessarily speak in grammatical sentences. That's a challenge. I think that
yes.
Ideally you would have the students would be exposed to natural speech. To the kind of conversations that people have, the way they actually speak in real life. You want to try to find maybe on YouTube videos where people are speaking, but where it's maybe less scripted and more natural.
And one more advice, two more advice that I want to offer to the English learners that we should. Try to listen to many accents because many people are speaking English around the world these days. We have Indian, Vietnamese, and other nations. So I think the best way to improve their listening skill is to listen to many voices of English in order to recognize their standard accent of English. And the most important thing is that I used to tell my students is not to use headphones or earphones when they listen to English. Because if you use earphone or headphone, the sound is clearer than you listen to English in real life situation. So I think if you use real earphones or headphones when you are listening to English, it it's not for you if you have to listen to English when you meet foreigners.
I train myself since many years in English, self-education. because I have learned French and Russian as languages in the school for many years, and so I work a lot and I don't have time to go to courses in schools or universities because of my busy work. So I'm going always to Facebook and to Voice of America and BBC English.
Well, we get a lot of questions from people asking what advice do we have for learning English. So it sounds like you've got some great advice. How did you learn these? So you're busy and so yeah. How is it again? You learned these languages. Just how did you use Facebook to help you learn?
I started with BBC a very simple book, and after this I found out on Facebook your website, and I'm reading the comments and I'm reading how other people in other countries they learn in the same way English like me, what they have for questions, and I also watch your channel. And I also have English friends in America, and
Skype, yes.
And I visited London and Los Angeles and New York, and this is how I train my English. And I read every day magazines, fashion magazines and news, but especially fashion magazines. Yeah.
I have learned English by myself, sir, and I am not very classical learned. I didn't classical learn English, but I am very interested to learn and continue and try to progress my language.
So what did you do to teach yourself?
I started by myself by self-teaching. Since I think 1990, I think, yes, it's a long time, but you see how I can speak now. And that time it was zero. I didn't know anything. But now I speak a little bit, yes.
So what kinds of things did you do? I mean, did you watch movies? Did you read books? What did you find most helpful to you?
I started with cassette and a book during the tape. Do you remember, no? Before CDs and I started with the very very basic instruments, and I started with that, including a book, and step by step I listened at first and tried to read the book. After that, my job was in business field, and I had some contact with the foreigners like Italian, German, and England, English or Korean or other nationalities. So gradually, my English became a bit better. I mean, now you you hear it. So it was helpful for me. But my starting was with a book and with a tape. But my listening part is very very weak because I have faced with several nationalities people with several sense of the pronunciation, and it was very difficult. Even when now I am speaking with you, I understand you very difficultly. When I speak with with a Chinese, their pronunciation is different. And from the part of the listening, I am very weak. But for speaking, I think it's better.
My name is Abdelrahman Sayed. I am from Egypt. I am a fresh graduate from the faculty this year, from the Faculty of Electronic Engineering in Murfreesboro University. And I appreciate every effort that does from VOA Learning English. I appreciate this. Really,
thank
I
you.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate that. Well, let me ask you a question I've been asking other callers. How did you learn English? What do you think were the most effective strategies you used to help you learn English? And what advice would you have for other people?
Yes, the very important thing for learning English is the patience for learning any languages. And this learners for practice many words in everyday practice. Practice English in such very in such important fields in reading, especially in reading magazines, in reading every books. If you specialize in your fields, and from my study, I study communication engineering, and I used to learn English from writing and reading English because of my study. For communication department in our faculty, we learn for 5 years in this in English this materials. We have many materials. We have our courses that specialize in English. Yes. So, and my advice for them is practice and practice and practice.